Let's work through a high-low method example problem. So this problem gives us some information for five different months. We have total cost information and total machine hour information. We're going to use that to determine our variable cost per unit and then our fixed cost amount. So first, variable cost per unit. We have the equation there on the right side. But before we even dive into this equation, let's first figure out what our high month and our low month would be. And how do we do that? Well, we take a look at the activity level, the total machine hours. And we see that March has the highest machine hours, right, with 700. And May, with 300 machine hours, has the lowest. So March will be our high and May will be our low. Now, if we take a look at the equation, we see that we take our change in total cost at high versus low activity level divided by our high minus low activity level. So dollars will be up in the numerator. That's our 5,500 minus 3,000. Those are our cost amounts from March and May. We divide that by 700 hours minus 300 hours. That's our activity level from March and May. That simplifies down into $2,500 divided by 400 hours, or a variable cost per unit of $6.25 per hour. Now we can use this variable cost per unit to find our fixed cost amount. So your total cost is made up of your variable costs and your fixed costs. We have total cost and variable cost figured out. We just solve for the unknown, right? So let's use March as our example here. So total cost, 5,500 equals your variable cost, which would be the 700 machine hours times the $6.25 plus our fixed costs. Well, your variable costs will come out to 4,375. We then subtract that from our total cost to find our fixed costs to be $1,125.